Christmas Eve. We are going to have church on Christmas Eve, and then at 5 p.m. on Christmas Eve, we have a candlelight service. We would love for you to join us for the candlelight service that evening as well. Just a couple of things. We're so glad that you're here. I would encourage you, if you would, right at this time, if you just go ahead, take your cell phone out, make sure it's on silent or off. That would be great. Just make sure that way it doesn't ring during the service tonight. Go ahead and check that out. If you have any questions about the church later tonight, well, of course, we'll be hanging around. Some of the other pastors will be hanging around. Let you know, I'm wearing a mask. I'm not sick. Thankfully, I am perfectly healthy, but I have been taking care of one of my kiddos who is sick the last couple of days, so I'm wearing a mask just to kind of keep from spreading anything, hopefully later on. So if you see me with that, that's what's going on there, but would love to talk with you, love to answer any questions you have about the church, or one of the other pastors would be glad to answer that as well. Well, the choir and orchestra have worked really hard for tonight. We've got some great things for you, and so we want to start off tonight with prayer and get straight into Carols by Candlelight. Would you join us as we begin tonight in prayer? Father, we thank you for tonight. We thank you for all the hard work that went into making Carols by Candlelight possible, for everyone who participated in all the practices and all the run-up to this. And of course, Lord, we know, we understand the reason why they did this is not to glorify themselves, but to glorify you. And Lord, we pray that tonight, as we sing, as we celebrate, as we remember the reason for why we celebrate Christmas, that what would be honored tonight is you and your Son, Jesus Christ, and what he has done for us to save us from our sins. But Lord, tonight we pray that everything would run smoothly and run well, and that, Lord, you'd be with us as we participate. Father, we pray all this in Jesus' name. Amen.
glad that you're here. We invite you now, if you would, to stand together to sing together the first Noel, the angel that sang.
Thank you. Meek and mild, God eternal. peace on earth, goodwill to men. And we're going to have some happy shepherds that are going to come and help us celebrate that in just a few minutes.
Glory.
700 years before the birth of Christ, the prophet Isaiah said, "The people who have walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who dwell in the land of the shadow of death, upon them a light has shined. For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace."
Thank you. that you would just cause each one of us to seek your truth in a way that would bring us peace. In Jesus' name, amen. You know, Jesus did come to bring us peace. The first peace that he wants each of us to have is that deep, abiding peace that is within each of our hearts when we know him as our personal Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. That peace that will transcend this earthly life into all eternity, where we know that we will spend forever with him. The second peace is that peace that lies deep within, that peace that passes all understanding of any situation we face in this life. The heartaches we have, discouragement, disappointments, whatever it might be, God can give us his peace that will pass all understanding. And the third peace he tells us about is to live peaceably as much as we can with all men. The Bible tells us if it's within your hand to do a kindness, you should do it. And so during this holiday season, we ask that each of us examine our lives, look at ourselves, and see what we can do joyfully in service to the Lord so that we can live at peace with him and at peace with all men. Brother Aaron and his son Chandler have been singing some of these songs back and forth on the way to school, and they are going to share with us now a message that reminds us again, peace on earth, goodwill to all men.
Thank you.
ask what you are is an excellent choir that's sitting right out here in the pew. So what we're going to do is as you sit, you're part of a congregation, but when you rise to sing, you're a great big choir that we're going to sing for the glory of the Lord right now. Would you please rise, choir, and let's sing together.
Thank you. fill the darkness. Oftentimes we found a devouring beast called death that is after us. We're found in the shackles of sin. That little shepherd boy would pen these words, "The Lord is my shepherd, and I shall not want. For he makes me lie down beside green pastures. He leads me beside still waters." That little shepherd boy would go on to say things like this, "Though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for he is with me." That little shepherd boy was named David. And to that little shepherd boy, when he becomes king, comes a great promise that one of his descendants would sit on God's throne forever and ever. God himself promised he would come to be our shepherd. And when he would do so, he would come to save his lost sheep, to free us from the devouring beast of death, and to pay for our sins. And he did just that. You see, it wasn't by mistake or by accident that the angels came to the shepherds in the night. They came to the shepherds on purpose, because God himself promised to be our shepherd, to find his lost sheep. So the angels in Luke chapter 2 appear to the shepherds at night and tell them, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace on whom he is well pleased." Peace has come because the shepherd has come. And that good shepherd is named Jesus Christ. He is the one that we celebrate at this time of year. The one who has defeated the devouring beast of sin and death by living a perfect life and dying on the cross to pay for our sins. In doing so, he is the good shepherd who finds the lost sheep of God. And every single one who repents of their sins and trusts in him finds Jesus Christ as a good shepherd. You see, that's why we celebrate Christmas. That's why we rejoice in this miracle. Because the miracle of the incarnation made all those other miracles possible. We hope before you leave here tonight that you know the good shepherd, the one who came to find the lost sheep. There's never been a time in your life where you've repented of your sins and trusted in Jesus. We would encourage you to do that tonight. All your sins have been paid for by Jesus Christ on the cross. What he calls you to do is to repent and to trust in him, to believe that he is the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. We would encourage you to do that. It's as simple as asking God to forgive you and to save you from your sins. If you have questions about that, once we finish, I would love to talk with you about it, or one of our other pastors would be glad as well. I'll be hanging out up front as soon as we get done. I am going to pray and dismiss us in just a moment, but before I do, I told you at the beginning that everybody here did what they did not for their own glory, but for the glory of God. And they meant that. They want the praise to go to the Lord. However, the Bible does tell us in the book of Hebrews that as long as it's called today, we should encourage one another. And so what I want to do before I pray is I want to encourage you to encourage all of those in the choir and the orchestra, all those that worked up in the technical, because they're going to come back tomorrow morning and do this all over again. So if you would you give them a little bit of encouragement for what they did tonight? They did a great job. If you want to see it again tomorrow morning at 10:30, I am going to pray. After I pray, you are dismissed. Let's pray. Father, we thank you for tonight, where we can come together and celebrate the birth of our Savior. Lord, we thank you that the Good Shepherd has come to save the lost sheep. And Lord, we pray that if anyone here does not know that truth, this would be the night they come to know you as Lord and Savior. Lord, we thank you for the choir, the orchestra, all those that work to be shepherds or angels, those that worked up in the sound booth. Lord, we thank you for their service to your kingdom, and we pray that the message of the glory of Jesus Christ would be what is taken away today. But Lord, be with us as we depart this place, and may you be with us tomorrow morning as we gather back together. We pray all this in Jesus' name. Amen.